Hi friends, welcome to my channel. Today I am going to present the topic competency based or outcome based curriculum. So what are competencies or outcomes or objectives? Whether these are synonymous in nature, that is what we are going to see in this presentation. And very recently, before some 2-3 weeks, NCERT issued certain guidelines for competency based education. So this presentation is developed on the basis of the directives of NCERT, CBSE, etc. very recently. So what is a competency? Competency according to NCERT is a set of abilities, skills and knowledge help to perform a task in real life. So they are going to integrate education with life situations. So a set of competencies, a student who complete a level of education, say secondary education or elementary stage of education, should have developed a set of competencies. So a set of abilities, a set of skills and a required amount of knowledge for a successful life. So that's competency. So then we have to look about outcomes, learning outcomes. So knowledge, skills, abilities, values and attitudes required for dealing with real life situations. So they defined outcomes as, learning outcomes as, knowledge, skills, abilities, values and attitudes required for dealing with real life situations. So there are so many situations that are coming in our daily life, so we have to face them appropriately. So those capacities help us to deal with such changes, that situations. So that are the outcomes. And the objectives are desirable behavioral outcomes or desirable behavioral changes that can be observable and measurable. So these three terminologies, the competencies, outcomes and objectives, are synonymous to some extent. They are similar, but we can see objectives at many levels, at many places. But here the competency is at the top level, and the under which the learning outcomes and learning objectives we can see in the directions or guidelines given by NCERT and CBSE. So these three, the competency, the set of abilities that can be the learning outcomes of a program or a school level. These learning outcomes are specified using behavioral objectives. So now let us see what is competency-based learning. So there are four pillars identified for this competency-based learning, such as objectives, content, pedagogy, and assessment. So objectives, as we know, it's defining competencies. You have to define competencies properly, ensure the attainment of these objectives or the competencies, and which enable practice. So there are three elements in objectives, as they specified. It's a definition or clear description of competency, and there shall be provision for attainment of that competency as well as to practice it for a better performance. Then the second pillar, content. It's competency specific, core content or significant content. So not more content is more better is not the slogan here. It's only the required content or the core content or the significant content which is specific to develop a specific competency. Then pedagogy. Pedagogy shall be child-centric, inclusive, and interdisciplinary. Because in real life situation, we demand not discriminative knowledge, but interdisciplinary knowledge. So the pedagogy shall be interdisciplinary, inclusive, as well as learner-centered. Then assessment for learning and assessment in learning, or assessment as learning, is the suggested assessment procedure. The about learning is assessment itself is learning is realization here in this document, because while we are assessing something and we have to learn many things from that, it is not a considered as a teacher directed activity, but it is a teacher learner directed activity or self assessment. More stress to self assessment, then only by assessing something we learn something from a critical point of view. So assessment of learning as well as assessment as learning are the two dimensions of assessment. A criterion reference, objective based, and performance assessment is planned. A performance also shall be assessed, because the competency based education aims at facing the real life situation successfully. So certain level of performing the competencies, performing the skills is essential. And it also suggests rubrics for assessment. So there shall be a more provision for incorporating transparency in assessment by the use of rubrics. Then competency definition. We have already said about competency definition under objectives, and such definition will be more meaningful when it is based on the developmental level of learners, rather than by class 1 student have to acquire competencies of this level and for every class. And it is better to state or better to define these competencies by stages, or by lower primary stages and the elementary stage, secondary stage. Such kind of definition, that which is not so clear in the guidelines. So such kind of a stage-wise competency statement may be more appropriate than a class-wise definition of competencies. So the learning outcomes. The learning outcomes are formal statement of what a student can do. So how we can state learning outcomes? It's a very basic aspect and as well as an important step in competency-based education. It's a formal statement. It should be a clear statement which shall be communicated properly to learners, so that they should get an understanding of what actually they supposed to do. So what a student can do, it's a statement. And description of significant knowledge and skills required. So that's another thing which shall be reflected in the learning outcomes. The significant knowledge and skills required to attain through the course or program. Then the learning outcomes shall be integrated with real life. Should be observable and measurable. We have to observe, because we have to perform something. The capacity, the competencies, the skills shall be performed in real life. So we have to ensure its attainment. So to what extent the learner attained the competencies, whether he or she can perform it well in assignment required, that should be ensured. So in order to ensure that, we there should be provision to observe and measure the extent of attainment of these learning outcomes. Then skills that student can demonstrate after instruction, and in the learning outcomes there shall be provision for demonstrating the skill, demonstrating the ability that the learner acquired through the instruction or after completing the process of instruction or the completing the process of learning, whatever it is, and reflect the degree of outcomes. That's another level of this learning outcomes. There shall be a provision for reflecting upon the learning outcomes, that it will help on integrating these outcomes with life, and it also helps to improve the tools of education for teachers. The learning outcomes act as a boost for teachers and enable them to improve their whatever tools they are using for daily teaching. And the teachers should communicate the learning outcomes to students. That is very essential, because students have to know what they are supposed to do, points they have to concentrate in order to acquire a competencies or acquire certain abilities, etc. So they can, if we communicate these outcomes properly, then only they can evaluate themselves, evaluate their progress. What is my progress, to what extent, so what is my present position, so what should I do for further advancement, etc. And the learning outcomes can be used as an advance organizer by teacher. Advance organizer by teacher in teaching, in the process of teaching, because the learning outcomes is something which can lead the process of teaching to work out strategies for instruction and assessment. The learning outcomes provide a guideline for a teacher to plan the process of instruction as well as the process of assessment, and to help the teacher to select appropriate content, the significant content or the core content required to master the competency. And it can be used, the learning outcomes can be used for continuous professional development of teachers, because the teacher have to research and innovate new techniques or new resources, incorporate new resources for better acquisition of these competencies. So these learning outcomes in that way also helpful to teachers to develop them professionally. So stating learning outcomes, so how we can state, a teacher state these learning outcomes? We are familiar with stating objectives for our lesson plan. Similarly, the stating learning outcomes, let's have a look. Students will be able to, it's an example, students will be able to draw diagram of life cycle of butterfly after going through the topic metamorphosis. So that's an example statement of learning outcomes given in the document. And another one more example, students will be able to defend the actions of Mahatma Gandhi in formal classroom debate after a history lesson on Chowri Chowra event. So these are two illustrations of statement of learning outcomes. So let us see the first statement. Students will be able to, that's a common element, and there is an action verb. Draw is an action verb, or draw is the competency. Students will be able to draw. So that's the action verb, or that's the ability that learner should develop. And the object of the learning outcome is the diagram of life cycle of butterfly. So that's the object. And the condition: after going through the topic metamorphosis, so the learner should, or the student should, do an activity after completing a condition or a learning or an instruction. So these three elements are specified in stating an objective. Similarly, the second learning outcome, students will be able to defend. So that's the behavioral part. Students should be able to defend. So that defending is the action verb. Defend is the action verb. So students will be able to defend. What they are supposed to defend? The actions of Mahatma Gandhi in formal classroom debate. So students should perform. There is some performance. In the first objectives, the performance is the drawing, a diagram. And here they have to perform in a classroom debate by defending the actions of Mahatma Gandhi. And the condition is that after a history lesson. So the third element is the after a history lesson on Chauri Chaura event. So by stating a learning outcome, that statement should be very clear in terms of action verb, the object, as well as the condition or the instruction or learning process. So these three elements are inevitable in learning outcome. Then the learner shall be, it is so communicative, so learner can understand it very easily. So that's about the learning outcomes and the nature of lesson. So the how should be the lessons or lesson plans, and there are some guidelines on the basis of nature of lesson also. And there is an abbreviation, engage. The lessons shall be engaging in nature. So that engage, so each letter has some expansion. E stands for energized lesson. That's the first phase of any lesson, in which it is before the lesson and going to start the lesson. So that's a phase, that the beginning phase. In traditional class, we call it as the that elicitation of this previous knowledge, etc. Like that introductory part of lesson, the first E, that in the engage, for energize the learners towards the class activities. And the N in engage stand for navigate content, and it's a teaching and a review can be done at the second phase of the lesson. And third is generate meaning, in which learners are reflecting upon what actually they are introduced, what knowledge or what competency or what ability or what experience which is to which they are exposed. So the reflection is reflected in the G, generate meaning. A, apply to real life. So they have to demonstrate the skill, because after that conduct of that instruction, or after going through that learning experience, and they have to demonstrate the skill. That's apply, A. And the second G, gauge the learning. They have to entry a journal or portfolio. So what they have acquired, they have to record it properly. And E, the second E in engage, extend to further activities. Or whether in which all situations they can use this particular capacity or skill, etc. So that such kind of an engage is the slogan for developing lessons and the nature of lessons that energize learners, navigate content, generate meaning, apply to real life, gauge the learning and extend. So that's a specificity of the nature of lesson. So you can get more details of this MHRD as well as CBEC guidelines in the URL given here. So today we discussed about competency based learning and competency outcome, learning outcomes, and the statement of learning outcomes, its importance, significance, etc. So there is a transformation from a memorization or based learning to more life oriented, learner centered learning is what MHRD or the NCRT as well as CBSE is planning, and they are issued certain guidelines in that direction also. So that's the end of this presentation. Thanks for watching.